Before we start, let's discuss the problem we're trying to solve with Canary deployment. To illustrate the Canary, I'll use a simple Python-based application that has HTTP API. We also expose Prometheus metrics that allow us to monitor availability, which is a ratio between successful and failed requests. Then latency, which is presented as P95 percentile, which means 95% of all requests completed within that time duration. And we measure requests per second made to our application. All right, you can see that the average availability of the healthy application is above 90%. Latency is around 1 second, and we make 1.52 requests per second. I have a source code available on my GitHub, and everything is packaged as Terraform. It's incredibly easy to reproduce this locally using Minikube. The instructions are also in the README file. Let's first take a look at a deployment with no Canary process, so we can later compare it to a Canary deployment in terms of general impact when we deploy application with a bug. In Kubernetes, the default deployment strategy is rolling update, which means it will gradually replace old pods with new ones. So let me update the version to v2 and apply it. Shortly after, we can notice that availability drops below 90%, latency spikes to 4 seconds, and our application cannot process the same number of requests anymore. This can cause a huge outage, since this change now rolls out to every single client of our application. If for some reason we cannot roll back to the previous version, we need to debug, release a fix, and deploy it again. In Kubernetes, rolling back to the previous version is as easy as changing the image tag. Let's apply it again. In a few minutes, we should see that application returned to its normal state. To improve this initial deployment process, we can utilize canaries in our rollout strategy to reduce the impact of a bad code push. Instead of deploying to production all at once, we need a way to create a small segment of production that runs our release candidate. We can then direct a small portion of the traffic to that segment, the canary, and compare it against another segment, the control. Using this approach, we can minimize the impact. First, I'll show you how to perform a canary deployment manually using only native Kubernetes objects. So you have already seen the deployment object. We call the control the active deployment that is already running in the cluster. We also need to add additional labels, such as type equal to control, which we'll use later in the pod monitor object. Next is the pod monitor custom resource to monitor our application. This one will only scrape the control portion of our deployment. Next is another pod monitor that will scrape both the control and canary pods. It may seem redundant, but I use it in Grafana to demonstrate the difference. Next, we have a service object that selects all pods, both control and canary pods. Then we have a canary deployment with a new v2 version. Now, to shift only 10% of the traffic to the canary, we can use replica count in this case. So let's set it to 1 replica and adjust the control to 9 pods. In this case, we have 1/9 ratio, 9 pods running the control segment and 1 canary. Since the Kubernetes service uses round robin to select the pod to send a request, we approximately shift 10% of the traffic to canary. We also have a pod monitor that is used exclusively to scrape the new canary pods. Now, this Python application exposes Prometheus metrics that we use to evaluate performance. For instance, if the version is v2, we simulate a bug by increasing latency and simulating failed requests with 404 HTTP status. Also, under Terraform folder, you can find all dependencies, such as Prometheus operator. Istio is included for the second example, as well as Flagger, Grafana, and other tools. You just need to run Minikube start and Terraform apply to follow along. By the way, Grafana username is admin and the password is devops123. Now, let's go ahead and apply Kubernetes manifests, including canary. You'll see that we get a new canary pod. As we continue running curl to simulate requests, after a while you'll see v2 version in the output. Again, this first dashboard scrapes all pods, both old and new ones. The problem with that monitoring approach is that if you only expose 5% or less, it's going to be very hard to detect the issue when scraping all ports at once. Yes, we can see a little bit of change, but it's very subtle. A much better approach is to monitor control and canary ports separately, as we do in this dashboard. Here we clearly see that availability for the canary release is much lower and the latency is significantly higher. Also, we can see that only a small percentage of the requests reach the canary segment. In the real world, you would immediately stop the release and terminate the canary. Now, let's assume we spent a little bit of time and developed a fix that we want to deploy next. Let's update the canary version to V3 and apply the deployment. Now, let's wait a few more minutes to ensure that new V3 version is healthy and has the same error rate and latency. Next, we can increase the traffic to the canary segment to 20%. For that, we need to scale up canary to 2 pods and scale down the control to 8 pods. Let's go ahead and apply it again. We can now see that requests for the canary are increasing, but the other metrics show consistent results such as error rate and latency. Next, we can slowly increase the canary count perhaps to 30%, then 40%, and then 50%. Let me skip ahead and shift 50% to the canary, so we split half the requests coming to control and the other half to canary. 50% is usually the final step. After reaching 50%, you either decide to roll back, or if everything looks okay, we can scale down the control to 0 replicas and scale up canary up to 10 replicas. So this marks the deployment as complete and we have performed a canary deployment. Now, there are few caveats that you need to be aware of. In Kubernetes, all pods are immutable. For demonstrations, it's fine to use canary and control labels. However, when you need to upgrade your app again, using control as canary segment can be confusing. In real-world scenarios, instead of control and canary, we typically use version labels. You would replace canary with V2 version and control with V1 version. In that way, you can move forward with new upgrades. Another problem with this approach is that most of the time we use GitOps approach. This means when we scale up, scale down, etc., we need to create a Git commit. So to perform this canary deployment, you might need to manually create around 5 commits while scaling the canary. Of course, you can create an operator, but you need to be very careful. There is another open source project called Flagger that can automate this process for you. It can work with native objects or service meshes. If you use a service mesh, you don't need to scale pods. You can use Istio destination rules instead to shift traffic. Flagger and Istio get deployed along with other components during Terraform apply. For the second demo, we need to create another namespace and use Istio label to inject sidecars into all pods deployed in that namespace. Then we have a regular deployment, pretty much the same service. You don't need to define Istio rules yourself, Flagger will take care of it. Then we have a canary custom resource that you can configure. For example, we'll start shifting traffic from 5% and gradually shift it to 50% while testing request rate and duration. These metrics are based on Istio sidecars, so in this case, metrics from the application are not used, but you can override them here if you want. The advantage of this approach is that you can perform a canary on any application with no need to expose custom Prometheus metrics. Also, Flagger comes with another open source project called Load Tester. We can provide the command to run to test the canary. In this case, it's a simple load test similar to curl. First of all, let's go ahead and apply the contents of the example to folder. But before doing that, I would suggest tearing down the previous example since Minikube doesn't have a lot of resources. Even if you have 2 replicas defined in the deployment, Flagger might take about a minute to initialize the application. I would suggest monitoring Flagger's logs the first time you perform a canary deployment. Alternatively, you can retrieve the canary's custom resource and describe them to obtain more information. From the logs, you can see that the app was initialized and we can trigger upgrade. To do this, we simply need to update the image tag to V3. Version V2 will fail since it has a bug. However, you can test it and observe how Flagger performs automated rollback to V1 version if you wish. Let's apply it and wait. Flagger also provides a Grafana dashboard for monitoring. This process might take around 15 to 20 minutes to complete, but in this case, you only need a single Git commit to perform the Canary deployment. From the logs, you'll see that Flagger will gradually increase the exposure of the Canary until it reaches 50%. After that, it will terminate the control portion and retain only the new version. I have another video explaining the most common Kubernetes deployment strategies. I also have a bunch of benchmarks for open source tools such as Nginx and programming languages, including Rust. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.